hey, Big Poppa's gonna show you how he cooks pork butts. Now we have Costco pork butts here. I think it's a little interesting and yet annoying about Costco, but I like to use them. I can't use them in comp because Costco doesn't sell a bone-in butt. Now you always kind of smell your meat a little bit, but pork always, when you break the cryovac, has a little odor. Pork doesn't have near the shelf life of beef. And this smells like roses on Valentine's Day. This is just awesome stuff here. See, we got this? And what I like about it, this is where the bone normally is, but at home, what I like is this gives me more surface to put rub in there to get more flavor. Injections. It's always nice to inject pork butts. You can make your injection on home. You can search the internet. You can use any combination of honey, sugar, salt, pepper, Worcestershire sauce, white grape juice, peach grape juice. I use our good friend Andy and Kim Groneman Smoke on Wheels pork marinade. This marinade won the Jack Daniels in 2010. Now the thing you do when injecting is you pick a spot, you pull it in, and as you push the plunger in, you move it out. And we want to get some extra flavor in there, and we want some extra moisture. Over. Okay, so we have them injected now. Now we're gonna start seasoning with our jalapeno maple rub, but we're gonna season the fat side first. The reason why we're seasoning the fat side first is we're gonna turn it over, and I don't mind if the fat side gets a little messed up, because I want the top side, that's where I'm gonna get the bark from. Bark is the caramelization of the seasonings interacting with the juices of the meat that forms a really delicious crust. So we're gonna start with little Big Poppa's bacon maple jalapeno rub. And we're gonna be a little careful with this because it's got jalapeno in it, but what I'm doing is I'm layering this for a reason. Back the old tried and true Big Poppa money rub. Don't be afraid to use it. It's gonna put a little brown sugar on it. See that? Deep tissue, massage, little shiatsu, and we're looking good. Now we're gonna hit it with some happy ending. Okay, you're gonna get all sides like this, but see that? That's beautiful. We're gonna cook this at 275, and these bad boys are ready to go on the cooker. Look at this. We're not gonna worry about temping these either. We don't need a probe, we're gonna use the timer. In 3 hours, or 150, 155, we'll be back. Okay, the pork butts, they've been on for 3 hours, and now I'm gonna foil them. The double wrap foil. I'm gonna take the first one, I'm gonna lay it in the center here. Take this. Remember, when you're foiling, you want as much air out of the thing as possible. A little bit of apple juice down the back. Again, you foil above the water line. So if it starts giving out a lot of stuff, and you can foil it, you can cook it in the pan now too. I'm gonna be a little bit careful. Even though it's double wrap, some of these sharp ends. And these should be done in about 3 hours. We're good to go, back on the smoker. Gonna probe them, we're gonna pull them at 203. Time to check the pork. Again, just like the brisket. Ooh, look at that, went in like nothing. Now look, it's right where I want it to be. But I'm gonna show you a little something today. I'm gonna show you something called FTC, which is foil, towel, and cooler. Wanna get the cooler, the C of FTC. One of the things you want to do is take a beach towel, one that you won't get in trouble for using, put it in the bottom of the cooler. Put it in the sides because it's so hot, you don't want to melt the insides of the cooler. So here we go. Another towel in there. So like if you want to make pulled pork and take to a friend's house, you want to make pulled pork the night before, you've got it. Because right now we've FTC. Let's see how these bad boys came out. A couple things to remember with this. is that because it's still hot to your hands, doesn't mean that it's safe to eat. Be aware that you've got to keep the food above 145 to stay out of the bacteria zone. So it's always good to thermopin, which I did off camera, or monitor your temperature. So we're gonna lift it out. Oh yeah. We're gonna save some of that juice, okay? Now, if you really wanna hold it really hot, get like a real hard Iglo or Coleman cooler. These disposable ones are for shorter period of time. These soft ones, oh, it's just falling apart here. Love it. Pulling is a very delicate thing to do. Look at this. Oh, it's coming apart nicely. Good bark. Now, a couple things to do when you're pulling it. If it's a little dry, bring it back with a little apple juice. What I like to do, see, I have no moisture problem with this at all. It is good to go. Apple juice or some of the pan juices. I'm just gonna use a little bit of pan juice. Okay, so remember that had apple juice, has a little fat, but not bad. The trick I like to do though, is to take a finely ground rub. Either grind your favorite rub or use what I use, Big Poppa's Happy Ending. Kind of sprinkle it on here. You are good to go. You're good to go with sandwiches. You're good to go with tacos. You're good to go with enchiladas. You're good to go with anything. But here you go. Smoking easy, easy smoking. That's our slogan. Keep on smoking.